Hello, and welcome to Honeywell Lake Ventures' presentation on energy-based surgical devices. The field of energy-based surgical devices has been growing and changing for nearly 100 years. At its current state, the market for these devices is estimated to be around $6 billion. With an estimated compound annual growth rate of 6.7% for the next 5 years, the market will grow to $8.4 billion by 2025. This growth can be attributed to the recent widespread adoption of energy-based surgical devices in the vast majority of surgical operations. The applications for energy-based surgical tools are wide-reaching: treatment of heart problems using the electrical properties of scar tissue, pain management through nerve ablation, and novel cancer treatments are just a few. The modalities that energy-based surgical devices encompass are also diverse. Radiofrequency ablates tissue by passing electrical AC current between a probe and a return electrode. Microwave tools ablate tissue using an antenna that emits electromagnetic radiation. Ultrasound technologies have a variety of submodalities, such as high-intensity focused ultrasound and deep heating, which can provide various therapeutic advantages. Pulse field ablation is an application of DC current to induce apoptosis in cells within target tissues. Laser techniques are a direct application of heat using a variety of lasers, including carbon dioxide lasers, argon lasers, YAG lasers, and low-level lasers. Cryogenic technology encompasses rapid freezing and thawing of tissue to induce necrosis. Sometimes, more than one modality will be utilized in conjunction with another because of the various strengths each technology has in a specific therapy. Each modality is accompanied with a unique set of challenges that medical professionals may encounter. The need for precise control of energy used in surgical devices is paramount in performing effective procedures. With new innovations and modalities, clinician training and safety is another challenge in the field. Devices that are dangerous and hard to use will not readily be adopted by clinicians who are already trained and familiar with a specific technique. Additionally, modalities that cause tissue to be heated or frozen may cause collateral damage in areas that are dangerous to the patient, such as the bowel. Finally, imaging modalities and feedback control that can assist in procedures are often necessary for medical professionals to be successful. As medical professionals are faced with challenges, so are the manufacturers of these devices. The control and feedback loop of an active ablation presents technological challenges because basic temperature or voltage may not correctly signal how tissue is reacting. The size constraints of the tools are also increasingly being pushed smaller and smaller, posing technological challenges that require innovative solutions. The management of carcinogenic surgical smoke that is created during an ablation, which has proven to be dangerous, is yet another technological challenge in the field. Finally, the integration of energy-based surgical devices into other technologies that allow for activities such as robotic control or imaging is accompanied by a set of issues that seek novel solutions. Innovations in a few major areas are expected to be successful. Tissue-selective technologies, such as those that utilize electroporation and are capable of both avoiding damage to certain tissue types and losing less energy, advanced endoscopic technologies, targeted nerve ablation for various therapies such as pain management, improved ablation techniques for cardiac applications as well as for tumors, as well as technologies that integrate energy-based surgical devices and other technologies, such as visualization, to improve on the basic device.